pretense, hypocrisy. It means to be different from inside and different from outside. Let's understand this through the example of Vibhishana Sharanagati. Vibhishana was a demon, the younger brother of Ravana. However, when Ravana insulted him, Vibhishana had actually caught Ravana's leg and begged him, "My dear brother, you have made a mistake. You have stolen the mother of the universe. Ram will not spare you. It is still not too late. Go and beg forgiveness from him. He will forgive you, for he is causelessly merciful." How could Ravana's ego tolerate such a thing? So he kicked Vibhishana, and Vibhishana caught his leg. And Ravana kicked him again. So Vibhishana decided, "I am catching the wrong leg. May as well go and catch the feet of my beloved Lord Ram." He renounced Lanka. From afar, Vibhishana saw Ram and Lakshman, and he went into samadhi. Durihite dekhe dvau bhrata nayanananda dan ke data bahuri ram chabi dham viloki rahyo thithaki ik tak pal roki nayan neer pulkit ati gata man dhari dheer kahi mridu bata. Vibhishana went into bhav samadhi. His body started trembling. Tears rolled out of his eyes. His hair stood on end. And he was just looking at Ram in divine love. For a long time, Vibhishana remained absorbed in that samadhi. Then he controlled himself. And he came right in front of the Lord. Now, how did he present himself? That is the point to be understood. He said, "Nath dasanana karame bhrata." Maharaj, that Ravana who has kidnapped Mother Sita and to kill whom you have come here, I am the brother of that demon king. Consider how fallen I am. I have no qualification to be here. Hare Vibhishana, just because your brother is a demon doesn't disqualify you. No, Maharaj, hear further about myself. Nisicharo vansha janma sura trata. I have been born in a dynasty of Rakshasas, and you are Suratrata, the savior of the celestial gods. Ram said, "That is also all right. Prahlad was also born in a Rakshas kul. To deliver Prahlad, the Lord took an avatar as Nrisingh." "No, Maharaj, please hear further. Sahaja papa priya tamas deha jatha ulu kahi tam paraneha." "Just like the owl loves darkness, my Lord, similarly I have a tamasic body. All my life I have done sin." "Really? Then why have you come here?" "My Lord, only for one reason. Shravana suyasha suniyaehu prabhu bhanjana bhava bhira trahi trahi arat harana sarana sukhad raghubir." "I heard your glory, suyash. Hanuman explained to me that you are sharanagat vatsal. You accept those who surrender at your lotus feet. For that reason, my Lord, I have come here. Now you may accept me or reject me. That is your choice. So Ram, of course, accepted him. He addressed him as Lankesh, the king of Lanka. And he asked for water and did the Raj Tilak of Vibhishan right away. Sugriva was astonished. He said, you have made Vibhishan Lankesh. What if Ravan comes to your feet tomorrow? You will accept him as well. What will you give to Ravan? The Ram says in the Valmiki Ramayana, Anayainam Harishreshtha Dattamasya Bhayam Maya Vibhishanova Sugriva Yadiva Ravana Swayam. Are Sugriv, if Ravan comes, I will accept Ravan and make him Avadhesh. My Charan Padukas are on the throne of Ayodhya. Bharat is worshipping them there. I will offer that throne to Ravan and spend the remaining 11,000 years of my avatar in the forest, but let Ravan come to my shelter at least. Sugriv's intellect was corrected. He remembered the time when he had first seen Ram. He was living on the Rishyamukh mountain along with Hanuman. When Ram and Lakshman passed by searching for Sita, Sugriv saw them and shuddered in fear. Who are these? Hanuman said, I don't know. Find out, they may be Bali's people. In case they are, I'll run from here. Hanuman went and found out and came back and said, they are not Bali's people, they are the Supreme Lord. Sugriv did not believe. He tested Ram. And as a result of the test, he understood Bali Badhab in a Bhai Paratiti. He can kill Bali. For his self-interest, he established friendship with Ram. Sugriv thought, where am I? First, I didn't believe. And then, motivated by selfishness, I contracted this relationship with the Lord. Compare that with Vibhishan. He saw the Lord from far and went into Samadhi. But what is exemplary in Vibhishan's Sharanagati is the way he presents himself. With all humbleness, I have no qualification. It is your grace alone, my Lord, on which I have faith. The reverse of this is Anrit Bhav. Guruji, I do 25 mala jap and I have done 4 dham yatra and I have got 5 factories and 6 bungalows and I have been around the world 5 times. Really? And your defects? Ooh, how can I tell them? To say that, my heart becomes dhak. This is not devotion. If we create such a persona around us, we will be victims of hypocrisy. That hypocrisy will lead to an artificial personality. The artificiality will prevent us from getting in touch with our inner self, the real self. And where is the question of surrender? We need to learn from the leelas of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In his times, in Navadvip, there were 2 very sinful people, Jaghai and Madhai. There is a long story how Jaghai and Madhai happened to come and surrender to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When they did, they asked, Maharaj, we committed so many sins. How will we be freed from their reactions? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, on the banks of the Ganga, build a ghat, a bathing place. And any Vaishnav who comes, you tell them your sins. Catch their feet and repent. And they did exactly that. Even if you go today to the city of Nabadweep in West Bengal, you will find this Madhai Ghat. But we people have the tendency to do the reverse. Oh, I'm like this and I'm like that. That becomes the obstacle, the hindrance, the stumbling block in the process of Sharanagati.